guys, Janelle Torkington of Epsum here today looking at a really popular efficiency app called CleanMaster, meant to give you a lot of different ways to boost your Android's performance. So I gotta admit, I'm really suspicious of almost all these kinds of apps, but this one's very highly rated, so let's take a look and see how it works. So the first thing it does is scan my device and tell me how much storage I have left. I'm at 51%, so that's not bad. Also, at how much RAM I'm using. Okay, great. So let's see what else it can tell me. I've just tapped on this information, and it shows me stuff about my CPU, which is overheating 31% higher than normal. You know, that might be because I'm recording the screen. So I don't really know if I want to fix that. It's not burning my hand yet, so I think I'm probably okay. And it shows me what apps are running. That makes sense. If there was anything I didn't want to run, okay, like Amazon shopping, I didn't realize was running and I don't really want it to run. Okay, wow, lots of stuff running. I guess I don't need all of this stuff. Okay, and then it tells me, like, don't make these apps stop running. That's good that it prevents me from doing something really silly. Okay, we'll boost it. And there's a really nice image of a rocket making me feel boosted. Found 11 games that can be boosted by 30%. See, like, I don't know what this means. I really don't like it when it when apps try and go over your head like this. I don't have any issue with stuff running on this device. Maybe if it were an older, crappier Android, things might run slowly, but this is a Nexus 5 and we keep it in good condition, so things work pretty well. Let's see what happens anyway if I hit boost. It gives me a nice animation and things are boosted successfully and I can launch things from the home screen, game boost folder. See, I honestly just don't trust this, and I've seen a lot of other user reviews that call it into question, because like now I'd be running the apps through CleanMaster for some reason. It just seems strange. Okay, now I'm a little lost in these menus, honestly. Okay, we've got an auto kill option, kill idle apps that screen turn off to reduce overall power consumption. You know, that's really not a particularly good idea to do with your Android, because the way that RAM works on a mobile device and the way that RAM works on a computer is different. With an Android, it's okay to have your RAM mostly full, whereas with a computer, you really don't want that. It's the CPU that you need to be concerned with your Android, and junk files. Like, I don't know what those junk files are. Maybe I can see what they are. Oh, it's just going to clean it automatically. Maybe I'm too much of a control freak, hey? Your mileage may vary. Okay, so it tells me what the junk is. Okay, can I see what my junk is in Reddit news? Image cache. Okay, well, I guess that's okay. And then I could look at each of these things and see what they are. Temporary files, unknown ads. Yeah, this does look pretty junky. Okay, fine, clean the junk, sure. And we're getting rid of all of it. I feel so squeaky clean. Advanced cleaning, big files, similar photos. Okay, let's see what this is. So it's scanning my device. We're gonna take a look at, I guess, different things I could possibly change. Oh no, this is actually kind of cool. So it gives me a rundown of different things it's detected that maybe are not important. Like similar photos, that's super useful. Okay, so you can see that this is the device clearly that we use for app reviews. But photos that are really similar, like why would I keep all of these of Santa Claus? And I don't want that one either. We'll hold on to one for posterity. These creepy girls. Okay, look, we use this for reviewing Android apps, all right? It's not really surprising that we'd have bizarre images on here. Yours will probably be cooler, but yeah, sure, we should delete ones that are similar. Put in the recycle bin, delete it after 7 days. That's great, so like in case I make an error, that's actually really smart. All right, we'll go back. Then there are big files, so I can see, some videos that I've recorded. Makes sense, I use this for making Let's Play videos. Also game data. I don't need the stuff for Kingdom Origins anymore, it was just for reviewing it. So yeah, sure, we can delete that. We don't need this from armies of whatever. Sure, and I can go through and selectively choose which ones I want to get rid of. ways, we don't need that, all right. And then it makes you feel good because look at how much you're cleaning, a huge amount of megabytes, and we get a cool trash can animation. I feel great about this. How to keep my naked selfies private. Well, I haven't taken any on this phone, but no, I'm not gonna start now. It's really slick. I gotta admit, it's head and shoulders above other cleaning apps that I've seen. At the same time, I gotta admit that I feel slightly funky about it. Like maybe it's doing stuff that I'm not entirely clear about. It feels like behind all the fast animations, it's maybe getting rid of stuff I'm not sure I want to delete. Do you know what's slowing down your phone? Find out about these apps that drag you down. I think this is content, like would link me to posts of theirs. Oh, it's a wizard. I don't think I want to restart 100 times in 5 minutes. Okay, so this is an article of theirs. Okay, if you're really interested in making your phone go fast, I guess you can read about that. And the naked selfies is always an option. And then we get awards for cleaning junk. And I beat 98% of other users. I'm trying to gamify cleaning my phone. I mean, I suppose it might work for some people. It's kind of cool. For a cleaning app, it's certainly got a lot of functionality. There's security stuff on here. Sure, we can scan it. Let's see what happens if we scan for security purposes. We don't keep a password or anything on this because, again, it's for testing apps. My browser history, and there's privacy issues with Facebook. That's a shocker. And I could lock it with App Lock, which I guess is another app or something that's associated. We're not going to do this. I'm at risk, I guess. And then I could read more. Oh, I don't really want to scan it again. No, thank you. It's okay. So like I'm impressed by the design, and I'm also impressed that it's keeping me kind of locked in and lost here for so long. Where am I even navigation wise? I have no idea where I am in the menu. And I have deleted some stuff on my storage because I started at 51%. So I guess that's cool. And then I have these options for junk files, phone boost, antivirus, and app manager. Let's check out app manager. Shows me what I've used in the last 3 days. Maybe I want to uninstall stuff that I don't use very frequently. Frequency will be displayed 3 days later. Okay, well, I just downloaded Clean Masters, so it doesn't know how frequently I've used stuff. I can see what APK files I have. None right now. What are picks? We're gonna find out about my best apps. Okay, well, look, if you Jelly Blast, okay. These are not even apps I have. All right, so if your Android is running really slowly, I think you could do worse than Clean Master. It looks like it might be really legitimate in terms of helping you figure out what you have on your device, what's taking up a lot of space. Stuff like the similar photos use seems really neat. You can quickly consider what's taking up a whole lot of your memory and get rid of it. Find out what you haven't used in a long time. Consider whether it's useful or not. But a lot of it seems to be bloatware, okay? And I'm not impressed by that. I'm really annoyed by it, actually. It's very well designed. But I see, like, this recommended apps thing, this is just ads. It's ads in a pretty little package. Another thing that I don't like about it is that if I go back to my home screen, check it out. There's magic things that appear on my home screen that I didn't install. This one tap boost thing. We can look at it, but like I didn't ask for this. It's a widget that automatically happens, and then it freed some of my RAM. Like what does it mean? What actually happened there? Is it a placebo? Did it actually delete something? I don't know, but I'm not thrilled about it. And then I can run games, I guess, through Clean Master. What's that gonna do? I'm not sure. Basically, look, Clean Master might work. I think it's one of the best cleaners on the market. That said, I would like it to be far clearer in terms of what it's actually doing when you're boosting and cleaning and whatnot. I'd like specific documentation of what's going on here. It also definitely shouldn't install widgets without asking your express permission first. The pages that are ads that are disguised as recommended apps or whatever that are totally unrelated to cleaning is also not too cool. But if your Android's running slow and you're looking for something to help you sort out what's taking up a lot of space, Clean Master is not a terrible choice. Maybe I'm just a worrywart, all right? And this app is not for me. Well, see, I didn't want that. But maybe I did. I don't know. It's like I said, if you're looking for something to help you get your Android running faster, give it a go. And do let me know how you like it. It's one of the better ones out there.